even held a subtle assumption that people on your team and in your company aren't going to figure it out without you. Would you take a vacation? Would you be able to put your BlackBerry down? Would you truly delegate? Would you give accountability? Would you give ownership? Here's what we found they did. In terms of how they manage talent, they tend to be empire builders. They love to hire A players. They love to hire smart people. And then they just take them and they put them in a background, sort of behind glass on display. Smarts in the company, but not well utilized. The environment they create is one of tyrants. It's full of anxiety, and we know what happens to our brains under conditions of anxiety. For the cognitive psychologists out here, people who study psychology, what happens? What part of our brain takes over when we feel anxiety? Well, the neocortex shuts down, and the amygdala takes over. They call it the amygdala hijack. And when the amygdala takes over, you go into that basic survival mode of how do I just get out of this meeting? And what's interesting is all the parts of your brain that does analytics, logic, reasoning, thoughtful thinking, it shuts down. And what's fascinating about this is it takes 20 minutes once you're no longer in that stressful situation for your brain to start working again. It's why when you leave a meeting and you go back to your desk and you fire up your email and then you suddenly go, oh, I totally knew the answer to that. Why didn't I say that? It's because your brain shuts down. So we get kind of stupid when we're in these environments. How do they set direction? They tend to be know-it-alls. They set direction based on what they see, what they know, their expertise, maybe the functional expertise they came from. How do they set direction for the and make decisions inside the organization? They tend to be the decision maker. They make those decisions solo or in inner circles, maybe really small councils. But here's the problem. The problem is that every important decision inside your organizations, every important decision gets debated. I guarantee you. But when does the debate take place? It takes place after the decision, in the hallway, over chat, hopefully not out on Twitter. You know, it takes place out in the organization where people are trying to figure out what's going on. And sometimes it's, hey, what was she thinking? But sometimes it's just, I don't understand. I don't really know what I need to know. They can't execute. And they tend to be micromanagers. They tend to hover over every detail because people won't figure it out without them. And we've already gone through, they get less than half of the capability of the people around them. Multipliers. Multipliers see the world very differently. They look out on people and they see a lot of intelligence. They see lots of ways that people are intelligent, and they have a very simple conclusion. And it's like a little ticker tape that goes around in the head, and it says, people are smart, and we'll figure it out. What would you do if you really came to work every day and said, I work around brilliant people, and they're going to figure this out? What would you do? Shout it out. You would relax. I love that one. What else? What would you do? You would empower them. What would you do? Give me specifics. You'd be a cheerleader. What else would you do? If your people are smart and they're gonna figure this out, challenge them more. So yes, you can relax for a moment, but then you're gonna say, you know what? I can push harder. Because the harder I push, the smarter they're gonna get. What else would you do? You would coach. Because your people are going to figure it out. It's the dominant mindset of these multipliers. Here's what they do. Each one of these comes with a little bit of a deal. The first is that they're talent magnets. They attract talent, they find people's genius, and then they utilize it to its fullest. And here's the little deal that goes with each one of them. And it's kind of this little arrogant deal, but they have a sense of, if I can figure out your genius, I can put you to work. And with that deal, everyone in the organization works for them. When you're a multiplier, you don't care who's on the org chart. You don't care who reports to you. You're going to put everyone to work. You can put your boss to work. This is why I always like this so much. They tend to be liberators. They create an environment where people can do their best thinking. But again, it's a deal. I'm going to give you space, a lot of space to do your best thinking. But in exchange for that, you give me your very best work. They're unrelenting about demanding that people, in exchange, give them their very, very best work. They tend to be challengers. They create stretch that causes people to feel a little bit uncomfortable. The liberator, in some ways, makes people feel very comfortable, safe to do your best thinking. The challenger makes people feel uncomfortable.